Hello, this is Matt Wright.
This is Jeremy Elliott.
And we are back from Thanksgiving, day after Thanksgiving, about 10 something in the morning. And we're back to do some more sessions here for y'all to watch and learn about.
I wanted to say that today that Tupac was coming through to me earlier today. I was listening to his album and he was coming at me very much like a hologram, you know, dressed in a white, like tuxedo, with a white t-shirt and white pants and dark shoes. We discussed this earlier, and he's been anxious to come through all day. I can feel Tupac's vibe now. I got music playing in the background to kind of, but he's in front of me, you know. Tupac is in front of me. So earlier we played a game. I know this. It's almost like he was doing this, and I was doing that back to him. We kind of did this back and forth, and smiles on our face.
It's interesting, you know.
But he's ready to come through.
Yeah, I can too. I can feel like it's like in a kind of like there's electricity kind of in the air, that vibe of you know, looking forward to something. Or
yeah, he's actually. We're very vocal, you know what I mean, right now.
Well, let's go with it.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, let's do
let
it.
Let him talk.
Exactly.
Help me if you ask questions. Yeah.
Well, look, Pop, man, appreciate you, you know, coming through, that's for sure, man. You know, I think what I do, you know, it helps Jeremy when I ask him questions, but you might, I know you're going to think of things I'm not going to think of today, so I'm going to let you do take the lead on some stuff.
He said to me, you know, just relax, dude, man. He said, it's fine. Ask me whatever you want to ask me. You know what I'm saying?
Alright. Well, so how's things been in the spirit world, man? How you like it over there compared to here?
He's saying, like, you know, it's no thing. You know, it's just like being there. He said, but we feel a whole lot better. You know, you
ain't
got all that to worry about, you know.
I can understand that.
Maybe those are the exact words. That's the best way I can relate it. You know what I'm saying?
Worry-free. Don't have what to worry about. Clarify that. Just worries of the world, money, food,
money,
living, and all that stuff.
Money, bitches. That's what he said.
Go ahead with it. I'm listening.
Yeah. He said, anything you worry about now, you won't be worrying about right now, you know, where I'm at, you know. He said, but, yeah, let me just let him say that, yeah.
I can understand that.
But he's trying to be philosophical, you know what I'm saying, but I'm having a hard time picking up everything that he says, so you know what I'm saying. So, let's just roll with it, you know.
All right. Well, let me think of so many things we could ask, but I'm thinking of for the benefit of people who are going to end up watching this too, I'm trying to be educational too. I mean, so we talked about this with someone the other day about consciousness over here affecting people in the spirit world, you know. Now, when you have a lot of people thinking about you here, it affects you over there, right?
He said, I feel the vibe of people all the time, you know what I mean? It's almost like that's what keeps him going, you know, to know that there's love on both sides, you know what I mean? He feels it in the air, but he said he feels it over there, you know?
Well, that's a symbiotic relationship. I was thinking about this, like, it's really symbiotic, you know. People here help people there help people here. It's one of the things that occur, you know. I mean, people don't stop caring just because somebody isn't, you can't see them anymore, some people.
You say, hey, I'm here to help you out.
I know you are, I know. That's what I'm saying, Pi, it's symbiotic, you know. I want to help you, you want to help me.
I know. He's saying it's very positive, you know. It's a
It's a positive. That's what it's saying. Like that.
It's just like this, forgive me, you know, for stumbling over my words, but I'm.
He said, man, you think you're the only person that ever stumbled over their words when they were talking to me?
Or talking to anybody. This is what I do. I'm just trying to. No, it's not that. We talk. I can deal with. Anyway, you know what I'm saying, Pop. Don't mind me, man. You've probably been around me before, and I'm sure you've seen me around. But this is just how I am. But what can we say, man?
Don't get me wrong, brother. He said, I'm not trying to be conceited.
You're not. I don't take it like that at all.
He said that in this world, you know, all he got was people trying to talk to him and all that. It was a bunch of nonsense. And, you know, this is something real. He wants to contribute, you know. He sees us poking through the same way he's trying to poke back, you know.
And again, that's very much appreciated, you know. So what would you tell people that you knew in this dimension here that we're in still, you know, if you could, you know, about living life better in the physical world? You have any comment on that?
Well, I think that the respect aspect, he's trying to show me that it's like he's holding himself like, you know, he did the best he could, you know. So you do the best you can, you know. You do the best you can, and that's all you can do, because people think you have 100 years to live. Don't mean that's not it. You know, your 100 years going to be 200 years somewhere else, 300 years somewhere else. So, you know, just do the best you can. See what I'm saying? You feel it? And he said he would come back. You know, he said that he would come back. He's back. He's trying to say he's back. You know, if he could come back from the dead, he said he would come back. So he was saying, look, here I am, world. I'm coming back. I'm using Jeremy. I'm using that. But I'm back.
You know, I mean, it's not like you were ever gone. Now, in a lot of people's understanding, you know, yeah, in their minds, people are so-called dead, they're gone. You know, I mean, now to us, when people die, it's nothing. But, I mean, it's just a change. But
everybody's trying to work on that 100-year thing, you know what I'm saying? I see what he's trying to say.
Isn't that trying to say that people are trying to get so much out of so... put too much into their lives and too much thinking they're going to go on forever?
Well, yeah, they're emphasizing on being something too much in this world, you know, this lifetime, when if they just only knew that there's more to go, you know what I mean? You know.
Well, that's some of the things I teach people, Pop. I like to tell people, look, you got to live in this and the now and know and live your life physically here while thinking about your eventual so-called death. You know, like, think about your changeover. Live your life with your death in mind.
He's showing me like an hourglass, you know what I'm saying? It's a picture of an hourglass, you know?
And the sand is constantly dripping down, and the time is always running out.
But the thing is, he's showing me, you flip it.
And you flip it, it starts over.
And then you flip it again. And you flip it again, you know.
I like that analogy. That's really good.
That is a good analogy.
I never thought about that.
I had never either.
Yeah, because the sand runs out. The hourglass has sand or salt in it. You know, all right, yeah, people know. Yeah, they're going to know what that means. That's a real good analogy.
Flipping it.
I really like that. Yeah, it runs out on one side, flip it over. And that represents the changeover from physical to spirit or whatnot. It's like, you know,
he said it's almost like the clothes you wear and the colors you wear, everything, you just, it's always this, you know, every thought you ever have, you know, every motion you make.
It never goes away, it's going to be in there. You know, the sand is your soul. Is that what you're trying to say, Pa? Sand.